Good early evening, everyone. Welcome back once again to the Peach Belt Conference Softball Tournament 2017 edition. We have reached the apex, the climax here, the championship contest from the Peeler Complex in Milledgeville. Georgia College Assistant Athletic Director Al Weston, alongside Student Assistant Sean Montgomery here, set to bring you the action for the final contest. Game number 7 of this single elimination tournament. Hang in the balance, the automatic bid to the NCAA Regional. As for North Georgia, it's pretty much a foregone conclusion that they will head to the Regionals. Flagler looks like they have a strong resume as well, but could probably need benefit greatly from a victory here to solidify that fact. Flagler College going to be the visiting squad as the, what were they, number 4 seed? No, they were the number 3 seed. Yeah, number 3 seed. They just got done earlier today, taking down Armstrong State in the first game of the day that started at 10 a.m., went 12 innings long, and the Flagler Saints outlasted the Pirates. North Georgia, 43-10. And they just got done with a exciting walk-off victory where they utilized a couple of young Harris errors to finish off the Mountain Lions. So we're going to take a brief break here, folks, as we have the national anthem on the way, and we'll come back with your starting lineups in just a moment. As we return back to live action here, the final contest of the 2017 Peach Belt Conference Tournament for Flagler College. They'll bat first. Leading off will be the shortstop, Whitney Woodard. After her, the right fielder, Allie Ann Begale. The catcher, Mackenzie Conley, hits in the third slot. The cleanup hitter is first baseman, Natalie Murphy. Designated player, Maddie Murphy, bats after her. Then the center fielder, Garland Evans, third baseman, Maria Capos, who has had an outstanding tournament thus far. We'll tell you a little bit more about her when she comes up. Second baseman Morgan Murphy bats eighth. The left fielder Megan Miller will hit ninth. And the pitching for Flagler is Allie Marcano. We'll tell you more about her when she takes to the ring. They'll be taking on Kylie Smith, the talented freshman for the Nighthawks, a 26-4 record, making her 37th appearance and her 30th start of the season. She does have 16 complete games, a 0.93 on the ERA with 195 and a third innings pitch, 125 hits, 38 runs, 26 of them earned, 58 walks to 212 strikeouts over the course of that 195 on the innings. Opponents just hitting 181 against this talented freshman. She's having a great tournament as well, as Kylie Smith has thrown 10 total innings and picked up a 2-0 record. She's got the one win near complete game. She came one out away from a complete game with 14 strikeouts in her start, and then came in relief earlier today and pitched a few more innings, picking up, three more strikeouts for 17 total. 4:55 looks like will be your official first pitch start time. As Woodard digs in, she tries a bunt, drops it into the left-hand batter's box, and that's a fair ball. She's retired at first base. Tried to surprise the North Georgia defense and can't get on base. So Woodard retired. That'll bring us now to the second slot in Allie Ann Biggle. Biggle hitting 299 with 44 hits, 3 home runs, 22 RBI. Good speed at the top of the Flagler order. 39 stolen bases for Woodard, 22 for Begal. Comes inside, swung on and missed, and Begal will start off 0-1. Got her out in front, looks like, with that changeup, Sean.
Yeah, she's doing really well mixing up pitches early. I noticed that a lot last game. She works well on both sides of the plate, and she throws a lot of strikes. And anytime you're a pitcher and you throw a lot of strikes and can get ahead of batters, you can use more of your pitches and be more creative.
0-1 pitch is lifted foul back and out of play. So the count runs to 0-2. The confidence factor has to be through the roof for Smith here. As the freshman playing in her first postseason at the collegiate level and absolutely dominant. Maybe she's too young to know the difference that these games really matter a whole lot. 0-2 pitch. Came with the fastball up and in. Begal was leaning toward the plate and nearly caught that one on the cheek. A little bit of a smile from her as she spins her noggin out of the way.
Well, nowadays, you start at such a young age playing so much travel ball and things like that. So she's been in definitely harder situations. But none bigger than today, a conference championship game. Getting the start for her team as that pitch runs outside. And it's a lot of pressure, but I'm sure she's equipped to handle it. And she looks good starting here already with one out in the inning.
North Georgia ran through Francis Marion in the opener for them yesterday. North Georgia, of course, the regular season champions and number one seed. This one hit well to left, but with a beat on it is North Georgia left fielder Lexi Duncan to squeeze that one for out number two. Hotline drive there, but right at Duncan.
Yeah, excellent speed in the outfield for North Georgia. Both teams, really, but you look across the outfield for North Georgia and you see Duncan in left, Hartness, and then Anthony in right, and there's not really places to drop any fly balls out there.
Talented catcher Mackenzie Conley, first teamer in the Peach Belt Conference, gets out in front of that changeup and fouls it off. Conley on the year overall, 331, 13 home runs, by far and away leads the squad. Next closest has 4. And 47 RBI for the catcher. Conley, though, just did 222 for the tournament, but she gets it going right there. Sends one to the gap in left center. Trouble picking it out of the turf by Duncan. That's going to be a stand-up double for Conley, and she's trying to get her team going with two down.
Yeah, great piece of hitting there, a low line drive. Conley actually had the go-ahead run batted in. In their previous game to get them here. A 12-inning thriller.
So two down and a runner on second here for Natalie Murphy. Got one of the three Murphys in this Flagler lineup. I'm told they're all related, a pair of twins and then an older sister, I believe. Cut on a miss, and Murphy starts off 0-1. Seems like that changeup has been there on the first pitch for every opponent thus far. Murphy, 368 batting average, 2 home runs, 33 RBI on the season. Takes a look at a rise ball that rises far out of the zone. So North Georgia with that win over Francis Marion to start, just got a victory over Young Harris. Two tight ball games so far today. We'll see if that trend continues here in the title game. Lifted to the right side, that's the second baseman underneath, and deep squeezes it for out number three. So they get the two-out double from Conley, but strand her out there. No runs on one hit, no errors. They leave her out. We will head to the bottom of the first in a scoreless ball game. North Georgia coming up. We'll be right back. Bottom of the first inning, North Georgia going to send shortstop Sydney Sprague. Good to see her in the lineup. Scary ground ball that kicked up off of it. Looked like either her cheek or her temple in the first ball game for them just about a half an hour ago. So Sprague in there at shortstop. Center fielder Stephanie Hartness, then designated player Alicia Frierson. In the cleanup spot is going to be right fielder Kaylin Anthony. Shelby Hammontree, the catcher, bats after her. Sixth is Lexi Duncan, the left fielder. The second baseman, Jordan Deep, hits seventh. Eighth, the third baseman, Hannah McSwain. And then rounding out the lineup, first baseman, Jessica Finch. And again, they're taking on Allie Marcano. Marcano, a 23-6 mark. And making her 38th appearance, her 28th start. 20 complete games on the season for the freshman. Two freshmen going head-to-head here in the Peach Belt Conference championship game in the ring. Missing outside on Sprague to start her off. Let's see, 201 innings pitched for Marcano on the year, 143 hits is all, 59 runs, 50 of them earned, 97 walks to 203 strikeouts. So both these pitchers up over the 200 mark in strikeouts on the season, and opponents hitting just 197 against Marcano. She's a lefty. Not sure how much that affects the softball game. I know it's a big difference on the baseball side, but again, just the ball coming from a different area, it's got to be a little bit tricky to pick up, at least for start.
Yeah, she does a great job mixing her pitches up as well. She has a lot of pitches that she can throw with confidence, much like Kylie Smith. So it'll be an interesting matchup to see two of the league's best freshmen going at it in this one.
It seems like two very similar pitchers to one pitch comes inside and catches the inside black. It's 2-2. But two very similar pitchers, kind of diminutive in size, but still bring it with good speed. Got good spins, good location. I mean, they're just well complete pitchers already in their freshman seasons. The only difference really is just coming from the different hand. There's a fastball outside. Count a run full here to Sprague. Sprague hitting 372 with 13 home runs to lead the squad, 44 RBI. That also leads the team. And 50 runs scored. Plenty of run production from this talented shortstop, a junior. Swung on late and fouls it back off the fence. I think she's one of those Division I transfers for North Georgia, if I remember correctly. There is a couple of them on the Nighthawk squad. As I struggle to try and find my roster. There
she
is.
I only see Columbus, and she's from Columbus, so I'm guessing that might be the
high
school.
Got a transfer actually from Missouri. This one rolled to the left side and just beats out the slow roller. Tough play there as Capos did everything that she could to get it across, but instead it's an infield single. First hit of the ball game for North Georgia. And it puts the runner on first. A little bit of a delay as I think maybe Sprague hit the bag awkwardly, but one hit for each team now on the scoreboard. Hartness at the plate. Stephanie Hartness, one of the best hitters in the Peach Belt Conference. 424 on the season, 11 home runs, 43 RBI. One of those home runs came in this tournament, and it cleared the batting cage out beyond our right field. I don't know if you can see that on the view that we have on the camera, but it was just an absolute bomb. It was about as tall as it was long, and a very impressive home run from Hartness. She takes a strike there, though. Sprague over at first base if you're thinking about a steal, 10 of 14 on the year. Lefty-lefty matchup. Don't see that too often. Here comes the 0-1 inside. And 1-1 now the count. Hartness, another Division I transfer, so they go D1 talent back-to-back here as Hartness came from Florida State. Up and away, that's a 2-1 count. Hartness from Niceville, Florida. Should be nice folks there, I imagine, huh?
Yeah, it must be nice.
Pleasant town. Do you see it dejected? Like, must be nice. 2-1 pitch and try to bunt. Slow roller, going to trickle foul. 2-2.
Yep, just dropped the bat head a little bit too far there. It's always interesting seeing left-handers in softball because, like, you're not even in the box anymore. Like, basically, when you bunt the ball, it's like you're just gone and the bat's there.
Yeah, such an advantage with the smaller field. I mean, less reaction time for the fielders. those left-hand batters make things very tricky, and it's not fair when you have speed like Hartness at the plate to combine it with the power that she has as well. I mean, just she can drive the ball to all parts of the yard, and she drives one down into the corner, going to rattle around there. That's extra bases. She's coming up on Sprague. Sprague will check into third base. I think she's still dinged up. She went in limping into that third base bag. But that's a double for Hartness, and the Nighthawks are in business.
Yeah, rope right down the line, just past the outstretched arm of the first baseman, Natalie Murphy, and she couldn't corral it, and it got all the way in the corner. You think with the speed on the base paths, it's a good job by the right fielder to get the ball in without actually allowing a run, because that thing did go all the way down into the corner.
Well, Hartness was coming up on Sprague's back there. Might have been able to take three if it had not been for the delay there. I think, again, Sprague, it looked like she went limping into that third base bag, and she might be a little bit dinged up. But either way, it's second and third with nobody down. Alicia Frierson, the DP, now checks in. She's a .387 hitter with three home runs, 36 RBI. I feel like Frierson has had a solid tournament as well. Yeah, .571. She's 7-for-4 with a pair driven in. Swung on, foul back to the fence. She'll start off 0-1. North Georgia, real balanced squad. Got the pitching as well as the hitting. In years past, even title teams and things like that, it had been a pitching-dominated squad. But it seems like they've made advancements to be able to outscore some teams as well if need be. That one bounces up there. It's 1-1.
Yeah, you saw they didn't play the cleanest of games in the last game in the semifinal. Had four errors on the board and were still able to fight through that and get the win.
Can never count out the Nighthawks. A lot of experience as this one, a little late on the swing, puts a good charge into it, but foul. A lot of experience on this team as, of course, 2 years ago, they were the national champions. You have, in particular, Jessica Finch has seen a lot of great softball as the first baseman, the senior there. Hannah McSwain over at third is a senior as well. So you do have some experience in this lineup that has contributed to a heck of a lot of wins in blue and white. 1-2 pitch. Oh, nice spin there. Did you see that one? It looked like it was coming outside and then screwball motion back. Well, I guess that would be curveball motion if you're a lefty, as it went came back toward the right-hand batter.
Yeah, both pitchers have electric stuff, really.
And that moves a bit away. You see it sometimes, you know, but a lot of the balls look pretty straight from up here, but these last couple of pitches have been darting toward and away the plate. But a payoff pitch on the way to Frierson. Comes up and in, rolled to the left side, tried to tag at third, didn't get her, bounces the throw over to first and gets the out there. Nice play there by Capos to try and catch the runner sleeping, and a great finish on the other side by Murphy to glove the one-hopper, almost like an AstroTurf ball there.
Yeah, it was definitely a great awareness there by Capos to try to get the initial, and he realized that not to wait on the call and, like, look at the umpire, but just to fire the ball over at first for another out, and that really helps out your pitcher there, just being aware of what you have on the base paths.
Yeah, best part for the Saints, of course, is an out without any runners advancing. That pitch, I believe, missed for a ball, and snap throw to deep shortstop there as nobody was covering the bag. Thought they had Hartness caught off, and good adjustment there by the catcher to not fire one into center field. 1-0. Is outside, didn't get a chance to tell you, this is Anthony, Kalen Anthony, the right fielder, hitting .362, 7 home runs, 42 driven in. Anthony, 2-for-6 in the tournament, but not much to show for it, no RBIs or runs scored, those two hits, both singles. Here's the rock from Marcano, the pitch, and it looks like a fastball up. I got 3-0 for Anthony here. You do have first base open, but obviously don't want to load him up when you're getting into some pretty good hitters in Hammond Tree on deck. 3-0 pitch, and that one misses poorly as lost the handle on that offer. As that'll load him up. First walk of the ball game for Marcano. And it brings up the catcher, Shelby Hammondtree. Hammondtree has struggled a little bit here in the tournament, 1-for-6. But the freshman overall on the year, 329 batter with 9 home runs and 40 RBI. Bases loaded with Nighthawks. Let's see, what did I have? I had Falcon Frenzy. What can we do with Nighthawks? It's a nightmare of Nighthawks out there. With the bases loaded up. Yes, Lee and Chad, you can use that hashtag if you would like. Hawkum? Yeah, I'll save the Hawkum for them. This is to the right side. What does Hawkingham mean? Like I know that's a playoff of Hook'em with the
Longhorn?
Texas guys, yeah. but Hawk, I mean, how does one hawk another person? I see that as like you bother him a lot. You know, you're just always there. Hey, quit hawking me, you know? Knock it off. Anyway, 0-2 count here. Let's get back to the ball game. My goodness. As Hammondtree at the plate with the nightmare of Nighthawks as it's fouled back to the fence once again. Good battle here from Hammondtree, not giving up on the 0-2. She's got to think now about the opportunity to make a productive out. Looks like Flagler playing infield in. The corners are very close to the plate, but looks like the middle infield is also pulled in a bit.
As are really the outfielders, too, playing pretty shallow.
Yeah, trying to get something at the plate. Maybe you won't even allow a sacrifice fly here. That's another pitch up. Missed high on a couple of offers here has Marcano. So I'm not sure what pitch that is she's going for, but it doesn't look like she has the grip on it quite yet.
Yeah, she does a great job mixing up her pitches, and she really lives around the strike zone. So when she gets in these situations, she's really effective with a nice pitch right there, kind of like a rise ball with some run.
Yep, that was a rise ball. It also looked like it had some tail to it, like moving away from that right-hand batter. And Hammondtree had very little chance to catch up with that one. So two down now, and Flagler with the chance to get out of a heck of a jam here. If they can attack this batter, Lexi Duncan, snap throw down to first. And everything safe there. The first pitch was a called strike here to Duncan. Duncan, 1-for-6, a pair of runs scored in the tournament. On the year, she is 375 hitter with 7 driven in, 20 runs scored. Here it comes late on the swing, foul back and out of play, and Marcano is a single strike away from getting out of the first inning unscathed.
Yeah, she does. The poise of these two freshmen has been really impressive this weekend. Working themselves in tight situations, it just seems like they just stick to what they've done best and what's got them here all season.
0-2 pitch on the way. Well outside, going to be taken there for a ball. Yeah, both of them, particularly Marcano here, she was very busy in their semifinal matchup. I think she ended up with like somewhere around 140 pitches in that outing, 1-2 pitch. And that is fouled just barely back to the fence. Got a string or two of that softball as she was just underneath on the rise ball. So a lot of mileage on Marcano's arm already today. We'll see how that affects her as this contest goes on, particularly at bats like this where there's a lot of pitches fouled off. Like that one right there, yanked foul, and out of play. Duncan was all over that pitch. No home runs on the year for Duncan, but she was flirting with one right there. I think she pulls up a couple of spots in the order, if I'm not mistaken. I think she used to be like the 8 or 9 hitter, maybe even, as she's batting 6th in the order here in the title ball game. So Marcano has a new softball, rubs it on her side, and a 1-2 pitch, and that's well out of the zone. We'll get back to the wall, and the wild pitch will allow a run to score. Throw down to second, that gets away as well. So a second run will come in. Oh, my goodness, that's a shame. As two runs come across on a couple of defensive miscues, Good for the Nighthawks, though, as they take a 2-0 lead here in the first.
Yeah, in a game like this where you already know it's going to be a pretty tight ball game with both of your aces going, can't afford to really give up extra runs. And while the pass ball got past the catcher that time, a wild pitch, you really saw a throw to second that wasn't necessary, and it skipped away from second baseman and allowed another run to score. So here you are now with you had two outs and a 2-2 count and bases loaded, and now there's two runs in.
Deuce is wild here. Did you say that?
No.
Just let the people know? Okay, I got that one. Here it comes. 2-2 pitch on Duncan. She yanks and foul, almost catches her coach in the third base box there.
But that is number 9 today. 9 Deuce is wilds.
So Duncan here with the chance to drive in a potential third run. If she can pull off another hit. But, yeah, the first run comes in on the wild pitch. The second one on a throwing error as this is yanked foul. So there is one error on the scoreboard for Flagler. The first error of the ball game goes the way of the Saints, and it's a costly one. Putting the second run up on the scoreboard. Fastball outside, 3-2 now. Count runs full to Duncan, quite a battle here. And already a lot of pitches, up to 36 for Marcano here in the very first inning. Swung on a miss, and Duncan goes down on strikes. Back-to-back strikeouts to finish off the inning, but not before North Georgia picks up a pair of runs on two hits and one error. They leave one out there. One in the books here in the Peach Belt title game. It's North Georgia 2 and Flagler 0. They're coming up trying to answer in the second. We'll be right back. All right, we're back to action. Top of the second, North Georgia taking an early 2-0 lead, taking advantage of a wild pitch and a throwing error all on the same play to get their two runs. And Murphy, the designated player, I need to clarify, this is Maddie Murphy, as we do have a trio of Murphys. As I said yesterday, I think that beats a full house if you have three Murphys. Swung on, and it's fouled. It might stay in play. Catcher gives chase. Nice job there. Running out of territory was Hammond Tree, but she grabs it before it hits the dirt. So one out here on the foul fly. That brings up the center fielder in Garland Evans. Evans hitting 275, a home run, 14 RBI. Left-hand batter against the righty pitcher, and she takes a look at one up and away.
Evans hitting 275 on the season, started all 55 games for the Saints, 160 official at-bats, 44 hits, 22 runs, and 14 RBI.
Swung on, lifted foul, right side, might stay in play again. Did they grab it? Yeah, just shy of the first base dugout as Finch pulls that in. Finch, an interesting story. Her last couple of years, she was the starting catcher for this squad. And she moves over to first base for her senior season. But, I mean, she was a starting catcher for a national championship team. So to have your catcher sliding around out there and speaks well, I guess, for your new catcher behind the dish if it's helping you defensively to move one of the best defensive catchers in the all of Division II over to first.
maybe it came down to just like a need for a first baseman, and these two players were in the lineup, and they were just like, who could play first base between these two girls? And they were like, Finch was like, I'll move.
But yeah, to Finch's credit, she's done a great job over there. I believe she had an error in the first contest today, but that's the first error I've seen in her, I guess it'd be four ball games now here at the Peeler Complex since we did play our regular season matches here. Fastball up, 1-2. Capo sat the plate, and she's getting the job done. 429 batting average in the tournament, 3-for-7. A home run, 4 RBI, 2 doubles, so all 3 of her hits have gone for extra bases and 2 runs scored. Fouled to the right side, back and out of play. Wouldn't be surprised if Ms. Capos takes a spot on the all-tournament team. Of course, that'll be announced right after the completion of this contest, and we will stream that live for you as well, folks. Cut on and missed. And Campos goes down on strikes here. 1-2-3. Go the Saints in the second. 2-0 North Georgia. We'll be right back with more softball from the Peeler Complex. We are back to action. There we go. Let's go bottom half of the second inning. And North Georgia up 2-0, trying to add to it right here. Of course, the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament hanging in the balance here as the number 1 and number 3 seeds meet. No upsets on day 1 at all, and we get an upset in the first contest today as number 3 Flagler took down number 2 Armstrong State to advance here to the title game. This is deep, Jordan Deep, the second baseman. She's hitting 209 on the year, 6 home runs and 15 driven in. And she fouls the first pitch off. That's low and away, 1-1 now the count.
Are we looking for something?
Deep 0-for-4 in the Peach Belt Conference tournament thus far as this one gets fouled back 1-2.
Yeah, not a lot offensively from her so far, but she's played solid defensively at second base and has made a lot of routine plays and some spectacular plays also to pick up 2 wins for North Georgia in these first 2 contests in the tournament.
Yep, no errors for her in the field and 5 total chances. This one lifted deep and a leaping grab for the center fielder. Oh, my. That's one of the best players we've seen all weekend. As a heck of a grab there from Garland Evans. She covered a lot of ground and then took a leap to get the rest of it. Gold star on that one, out number 1 here in the second.
Yeah, deep really put a charge into that one. And center fielder playing in a couple of steps, Evans did a great job tracking back on that one, faded over her shoulder and just leapt to make the catch and retired for an exciting out number 1.
Hannah McSwain now at the plate, new third baseman. She hasn't started either of the previous 2 contests here in the tournament. Hitting 234, 2 home runs, 9 driven in. And she takes a look at strike 1. There's another fastball, looks like up. I think it's a 1-1 count here for McSwain. McSwain is senior, so maybe trying to get a little bit more experience and leadership into that starting lineup. She did play in both ball games as a defensive replacement. This one fouled back. Actually got some at-bats as well. She went 2-for-2, so getting rewarded here with a start in her third contest. Scored a pair of runs as well. Okay, yeah, that's a good switch. Go ahead and get yourself a new third baseman. 1-2 pitch, and this one is lined right in the glove of the first baseman for out number 3. Great play there, catching over the shoulder for Natalie Murphy. Has a couple of solid efforts here on the first two defensive stops of the second inning. 9-hitter, Jessica Finch digs in. 246 on the average, 3 home runs, 27 RBI. Preseason all-PBC pick at catcher, as I mentioned, made the move over to first base. Jessica Finch, she has played a lot of softball in the Peach Belt Conference. Ackworth, Georgia native. And a lot of success for this young lady. Strike taken there. It's 0-1. Obviously, they'll continue on in the postseason, but Finch probably looking toward the end of her career here, thinking about the end of playing softball. And you look back on a heck of a resume. Lifted to center, and with a beat on it, no problem there. Not quite as eventful as her first catch of the inning for Evans there. But that is out number 3 regardless. So 1-2-3 on each side in the second. We'll go to the third. North Georgia still out in front 2-0 here on the Peach Belt YouTube network. We'll be right back. Okay, folks, top of the third here in the Peach Belt Conference title contest. Flagler at the plate, trailing by a pair of runs. And leading things off is Morgan Murphy. Murphy 2-for-6, a .333 batting average in the Peach Belt tournament. She's got a double and a run driven in. Overall on the year, a .234 batting average. As she takes a look at a couple out of the zone to start her off. Morgan Murphy, then Megan Miller, then back to the top of the order and Woodard. Swung on and rolled to the left side. Trouble there as Sprague comes up firing. Throw gets away from Finch at first, but that doesn't affect the play any. It rattled off the iron fence down there. I don't think it's iron, actually. I think I'm making that up. It's more like a chain link kind of thing. But anyway. Either way, it came ricketing back pretty quick, so Murphy stays put at first base. Infield single for her.
Yeah, great job of hitting, just getting in the gap. Always a tough play for a shortstop in softball, trying to backhand and throw all the way across your body. So a good job digging it out with her speed and leading off the inning with a single.
Second hit of the ball game for Flagler as new batter is Miller. This is Megan Miller, the left fielder. She's hitting .211 on the year. Thought about a bunt on the first pitch as I think it missed for a ball. snap throw down to first was, of course, not in time as well. So Megan Miller trying to get the runner over into scoring position for the top of the order. Thinking about a bunt again. Instead, it's more of a swinging bunt, and it's foul back and out of play. Slap approach from that left side here for Miller. Megan Miller, sophomore from Land O'Lakes, Florida, and Wiregrass Ranch. I wonder if that's where they make the butter.
That's what I was just thinking, Land O'Lakes.
Got to think so, right?
I think so. It's in Florida, too, and there's an Indian, a Native American on the
Oh, and the logo there. Yeah, yep. You're right.
So maybe. No.
1-1 pitch, and that's poked at as a bunt and again fouled back. So can't get the sacrifice down. Got to imagine with two strikes, that'll probably wipe it off here.
That's been a real common theme of this tournament, really failing to execute on the little things. I've seen a number of sacrifice bunts and just popped up or either just fouled off.
Swung on and lifted to the left side. The third baseman going to have no problem with that as McSwain squeezes it for out number one. So they can't get their bunt down. There's one out now, and Murphy's still over at first base. Back to the top of the order in Woodard. She was retired on a bunt attempt for a hit to start the ball game. The shortstop now batting 299. After the 0-for-1, swung on, foul back to the fence. Up and away. Up and away, and it's a 1-1 count here for Woodard. One down in the top of the third, and Flagler trailing by a pair. Tie and run at the plate here. First one's always the toughest. Tries to bunt for a hit and instead tips it all the way back to the fence. Now 1-2. A little bit of attempt at a drag bunt there and came up empty on it.
Yeah, Smith doesn't really give up that many hits in a ball game, so you got to try to get on whatever way you can. Third baseman playing all the way back. There's a drag attempt there trying to move the runner over to second base.
1-2 pitch is up. And a bluff of a throw to first. Whitney Woodard from Moulton, Alabama, and Central Alabama Community College. Bounces off the plate. It's 3-2 now. As the Flagler shortstop trying to make things interesting with one down here in the third. Beautiful day here in Milledgeville, up in about the mid-80s, I think it reached today. This one is lifted to center. It will get down in front of Hartness. I thought she might have had a beat on it at first, but instead it's a single to center. So with one out, first and second now for the Saints. And Allie-Ann Biggle will step in. She flew to left in her first trip, batting 297 now. Biggle has a routine. Every time up to the plate, she grabs some of the chalk and writes something with her right hand in the dirt down the third baseline. Then draws a cross with her bat and digs in. Misses inside. It's always interesting to see the many things that the batters do. Everybody's got their routine. Some folks, but a lot of crosses drawn in the dirt. I've seen a lot of that. Of course, it is the South.
Yeah, I was about to honestly say that. Like, we are in the South.
Tries to bunt for a hit there, looks like, and they are going to say she did swing through. So 0-2 now. As each of the last three hitters have attempted bunts and all have come up empty on those bunt attempts. Of course, Woodard answered with a single to center after she had two strikes. We'll see what Biggle does here. And she fouls one back. Count remains 0-2. Third straight year, Georgia College has hosted the Peach Belt Conference Tournament in softball. It's our third tournament in the Peach Belt Conference, our third championship that we've hosted this year. Outside for ball one, got the volleyball championship, which Flagler won, I believe, right? And cross country was also hosted here by GC. I think we've got that again next year, don't we, Molly? Oh, Molly's not here. Okay. Oh, there you are, Molly. I think we've got that again next year. Cross country, I think, is coming back. Lifted foul to the left side, and it will get out of play. Giving chase on that one was the left fielder Duncan, but she ran out of real estate.
Sun's starting to creep out and cause problems for the left side of the infield and the left fielder.
Yep, you can see the shortstop, the pitcher, have visors on, but the third baseman and left fielder are shielding their eyes with their hands here. Fouled well out in front of that one is Biggle again. She rolls one into foul territory. But, yeah, if you haven't played at the Peeler Complex, it's this time of day, man. It is tricky for the left side of that infield. And equally as tough for the right side of the baseball diamond behind us. 1-2 pitch. Comes up and in, and spinning out of the way of that one was Biggle. As she took a couple of steps toward the dugout there, I don't know if maybe she thought that was ball four, but it's just 2-2. Biggle will dig back in and battle again here at 2-2. Good at bat for her as she pulls one foul. Another junior college transfer from Alabama Southern, but a Florida native of Marianna, Florida. She's a junior, so probably in her first year with the Saints. Flagler has been a very good team all year long. I was surprised at how low they were in the first couple of region rankings. Swung on foul back to the fence. Still 2-2.
Yeah, put together a solid 37-18 record on the season. I mean, it's always tough playing in the PBC. A lot of good teams towards the top of this conference, and then pretty good teams outside the conference as well that they've had on their schedule. So really one of those teams that aren't up here every year, but they're really making some noise this year.
2-2 pitch is hit well to left. Duncan trailing back onto the track, and she grabs it. Throw gets in, and that is out number two. The runners retreat back to first and second, respectively. But Biggle just missed that one.
Yeah, she definitely put a charge into that one. Off the bat, you thought it might have a chance to get out, but had a little bit too much air under it and just settled up for Duncan to make a play on that one.
So Biggle is 0 for 2 with a couple of flies to left. If anything's going to happen now, it's going to be because of this talented catcher, Mackenzie Conley. She doubled in her first trip. Gets a bunt down. Back to the pitcher. The throw to first is well in time, and that is out number 3. So the Saints are retired. Put two runners on, unfortunately, for Flagler fans. Leave them out there, and we'll head to the bottom of the third. It's North Georgia 2 trying to add to it. We'll be right back with more Peach Belt Conference softball in just a moment. All right, folks, how about bottom of the third here? Top of the order for North Georgia, trying to pad their 2-0 lead. Picked up both runs in the first. Wild pitch and throwing error on the same play. Brought both runs in. And Sprague with a big cut there. She was trying to add a run to the tally for sure with that swing. Liked that fastball up, but she couldn't catch up with it. Sprague, 1-for-1, a single. Came in to score on that wild pitch, as they did have two hits in that inning. Of course, Hartness ripping a double down the right field line as well. That pitch just misses, I guess, a little bit outside. We'll go with a 1-1 count here for Sydney Sprague.
Yeah, Marcano has done an excellent job today. Aside from that wanting to have the bases loaded and the wild pitch allowing the first run to score for the error.
Swung on, got lifted to center, and underneath that one with little trouble is Evans.
Yeah, just two hits given up on the day, throwing a lot of strikes, staying in the strike zone and out in front of hitters. Just that one miscue in the inning led to the two runs to score, and that really is the difference in the ballgame.
Yeah, it was a good start for had the single and then the double. But then she buckled right down, got an out without advancing the runners from second and third. Walked the bases loaded, but then a strikeout, and then it looked like they were about ready to get out of the jam when the wild pitch and error came into play. Hartness at the plate batting .428 now. And she digs well back into that left-hand batter's box. 0-1 pitch is, or 1-0 pitch is in there for the strike now, so it is 1-1.
Yeah, great job mixing up all the different stuff that she can throw. She can throw inside, outside, up, down, curveball, fastball. She has a lot of good stuff, and for a freshman, it's really impressive.
Hartness takes a look at another one, 1-2 now. As the veteran center fielder, we'll have to battle back with one down. Flagler Saints, one of the newer members of the Peach Belt Conference, 1-2 pitch. Up, it's 2-2. If I remember right, I think they came in with Montevallo. Probably about 8 years ago now, somewhere around there. Shortly after was Young Harris edition, and they're the most recent team. This is hit well to right, and the right fielder gave up on that one after about five steps, as it is well out of here. Stephanie Hartness, home run number 12 of the season. She got all over that pitch from Allie Marcano. The only good thing about it, of course, were the bases was empty, so that it's only a 3-0 lead. But that is Hartness's second home run of this tournament, as she put a heck of a charge into that one. So 3-0 now the score.
Designated player number 0, Alicia.
On the third hit of the game for North Georgia. Frierson at the plate, base is empty and one down. Rock in the pitch here from Marcano, low and away, it's 1-0. That was a well-hit ball there by Hartness. Marcano will see how she reacts to that and quickly evens things out here with a foul ball. Can the freshman here have a short memory of that mistake pitch? The 1-1 on the way, and it's well outside. 2-1 here to Frierson. Frierson's first trip was a ground out to third base. That was the play that Kapos made the tag on the runner at third, almost got her there, and then fired across the diamond. One hop to her first baseman. Misses outside. It's 3-1 here for the Nighthawk designated player. Marcano working quickly on the 3-1 pitch. Got that rise ball. A little bit of help from Frierson on that nasty pitch. Swung on and missed 3-2 at what would have been ball 4. So a payoff pitch here with one out and the base is empty. Came up and in on that fastball, and it's ball four. Second walk of the ball game for Marcano puts Frierson on first base. For the right fielder, Kaylin Anthony. Anthony walked in her first trip, so no official at-bats for her. Mound meeting here. So three runs on three hits for North Georgia. For Flagler, no runs, two hits, and one error. Couple of pats on the back here for Marcano. I think that might be the end of her day. She turns the softball over. So we will get our first change of the ball game. The new relief pitcher is Caitlin Smith. We saw her earlier in this tournament. She actually has a win in relief. 5 1/3 innings pitched. Four hits. And no runs, no walks, no strikeouts as she got the win in that marathon ball game against Armstrong, the 12-inning contest. It was 12, right? So Caitlin Smith will dig in here with just one out in the third.
Yeah, she mixes up well and is a bit of a change. Does a little bit harder than Marcano, lives around the strike zone. Like you mentioned, no strikeouts in the 5 1/3. But no runs either. That means she pitches to contact and she knows where she wants her defense to be set up to get outs. So not a huge strikeout pitcher, but still does well of getting ground balls and flyouts for her defense to make easy plays behind her.
Experienced ball player too, a senior for the Flagler Saints. Caitlin Smith from Palatka, Florida. And Palatka High, that senior, she must be in her fourth year with this program. She grunts and fires and misses outside to start off Anthony 1-0. Smith had great success in that relief outing earlier today. 1-0 pitch. And that caught the outside black. Snap throw down to first. 1-1 here with one out in the bottom of the third. North Georgia's already brought a run in on a Hartness home run. Low and away, 2-1 here to Anthony. Rock in the 2-1 pitch is lifted to the right side, foul back and out of play. Count goes to 2-2 here with one down. Again, both teams playing for Peach Belt Conference tournament title. Swung on and sent to shortstop. Caught on the run there, nice grab by Woodard on the sinking liner. If she lets that bounce, there's no telling where the spin would put that ball. So good idea to get it in the air for out number two. Two down for Hammondtree, a strikeout swinging in her first trip. And a good start for Smith to get an out without a runner advancing. Back to her. Smith with an underhand flip over to first. Four out number three. So the reliever comes in and provides some relief after the Hartness solo shot. Hartness put a hurt on it here in the bottom of the third. It's 3-0 North Georgia. We'll bring you the fourth in just a moment here from the Peeler Complex. Top of the fourth inning from Milledgeville, Georgia. It's the 2017 Peach Belt Conference softball tournament. Title game to decide the championship, the automatic bid to the NCAA regional as well. As we mentioned in the onset, North Georgia has all but locked up an at-large spot. Regular season champions once again in the Peach Belt Conference. Congratulations to Coach Davenport and the gang on that. But trying to add another trophy to the case. Got to imagine that case is getting pretty full up in Dahlonega. We're going to need a bigger case. Top of the fourth, and it's Murphy at the plate. She fouls one back. Natalie Murphy, the first baseman, hitting 366. She popped out to the second baseman in her only at bat. Smith has been buzzing through here pretty quick. Got 44 pitches is all so far and 30 strikes, so she's only missed with 14 pitches so far. As a cut on and missed, what looked like a curveball maybe there, working away from the right-hand batter. And now Smith is way ahead, 0-2. Back to her. Slow roller, and it tips off the edge of her glove. Will she still get her at first? No. Going to be an error on the pitcher. As it, I'm hearing that in my ear. I agree. It looked like she was trying to look up and make the throw before she had secured the softball. You got to secure the softball, Sean. You got to also turn on your microphone. Secure,
sorry. I think I turned it on, then I turned it down for something.
so you could take a nap, probably. Yeah. Murphy, the designated player. Tap back to the pitcher, caught in the air, and got her at first base as well. That's a double play. You pick up a pair of Murphys as well as you get the pop out and the throw out at first. You killed two Murphys with one softball.
That's a way to run yourself out of an inning right there. You got to make sure, especially in a sacrifice situation, that the ball actually hits the ground. And I've seen that a number of times today and throughout this tournament. Players just really just going ahead and charging on to second and a pop-up bunt. So now you have your leadoff runner on and then a double play. And a quick way to run yourself out of an inning.
This one fouled back and out of play. Count is 1-2 here to the new batter, Evans. Evans has had a heck of a game in the field, trying to add a little bit here at the plate. Foul back to the fence. And still a 1-2 count. Swung on and pulled to first base. Backhand attempt there by Finch. I don't normally give errors on backhand stabs, but she kind of got in the way on that one. We're going to give an error to Finch over at first. So that's the second North Georgia error of the ballgame.
One attempt there by number 14. Capos, and runs the count now 0-1.
So two down here with Evans on first and the dangerous Capos at the plate. A lot of bunting from Flagler, trying to just make the defense make plays. Not necessarily a bad idea. Four big errors for North Georgia in the previous contest. Swung on and missed there. And now Capos deep in the hole here, 0-2. They do also have two errors today, so that's six errors in the course of, nine innings. Rocking the 0-2 pitch. Runner goes. Pitch was a ball throw down to second. Did not get her. Head first slide, just evades the tag. Looked like the throw beat her there. Must have just gotten underneath the tag.
Yeah, the throw was kind of on more of the second base side also, and a shortstop running across fielded it and kind of tagged her a little bit lower around her waist area, and a good slide around the bag and getting your arms out there really made it look like she was safe, and so was the call.
Aggressive Saints on the base pass. They've got four different players with double-digit steals on the year. There's a fastball up 2-2. That's 13 thefts in Evans's season. She is
a thief.
She is a thief. She is a felon with 13 steals and 18 attempts on the year. 2-2 now, the count to Capos. And Deuces Wild here at the Peeler Complex. Cut on and just barely foul back to the fence. Runner in scoring position here is Evans. Obviously displayed good speed. If something gets to the out, he field here for Capos. Probably going to play to run. As Evans with two down will be moving on contact. The rock and the 2-2 pitch from Smith. In on the hands, up the middle, could be trouble. Sprague comes across, and a nice stretch there from first base as well. The first base coach complaining that the throw might have pulled her off the bag, but it looked like from here that was indeed the right call. No runs, no hits, two errors, and one left. Eventful inning, but nothing to show for it on the scoreboard for Flagler. Let's go to the bottom half of the fourth. It's 3-0 North Georgia here in the Peach Belt Conference title game. We'll be right back. Duncan, Deep, and McSwain do up. Easy for me to say here in the fourth as the North Georgia Nighthawks lead it 3-0. Got a battle of two teams that used to both be called the Saints, the Nighthawks, back before moving to the University of North Georgia were the Saints. Their mascot was a Saint Bernard. And made the change to Nighthawks when they changed their university name as well. It used to be North Georgia College and State University. We know a little bit about awkward names like that here at GCSU. 0-1 the count here for Duncan. She swings and misses at a pitch low and away to make it 0-2.
Yeah, 3-0 game, but really the tail has been a pitcher's duel. I mean, you look at the one inning they scored a run, it was off a wild pitch and an error, and really the only true run scored was Hartness's home run.
Yeah, it was, just a simple pitch that mistake pipe pitch, and Hartness, of course, is going to make you pay for mistakes, and she cashed in big time with that home run to right center. Swung on and fouled off the catcher here. Still 1-2 now. For Lexi Duncan. Duncan struck out in her first trip, hitting 370 now. The first baseman for the Saints, Murphy, comes over to talk to the pitcher to give this talented catcher, Conley, a little bit of time to work out the foul ball. 1-2 pitch, and I think that fouled off the home plate umpire's foot. So nobody's safe back there behind the plate. Foul balls for everyone. 1-2 count, nobody out here in the bottom of the fourth. Duncan trying to keep the momentum in North Georgia's favor. That's a nice ball down into the corner. Extra bases on it, and she will get into second base standing up. Duncan so fast. You give her a little gap, and she's going to take two with a double down the left field line. That is the third extra base hit of the ball game for North Georgia out of their four hits, a pair of doubles and a home run. And now Jordan Deep steps in. She flew out to center in her only trip, hitting 207.
It was that leaping catch.
Oh, yeah, that was that beautiful catch there that was it? It was Evans. Covered so much ground and then just ran out of time, had to leap to grab it before it fell on the track. 1-0 pitch here from Smith. And that catches the outside black, 1-1. Tough spot here, though. Runner in scoring position and nobody out. Kind of surprised to see Deep not square and try and get this runner over to third with no one out. Cut on, and a big cut there, too. Swung on and missed. I guess the theory is that Deep, with quite a bit of power, 6 home runs on the year. Going to take advantage of that at the dish instead. 1-2 pitch off the very end of the bat, and this will work like a bunt. Roller to second base. Simple little play there as Duncan will check into third now with one down.
Third baseman number 7, Hannah McSwain.
McSwain steps up. A liner to the first baseman in her first trip. Right-hand batter, the senior, digs in with a run on third base. There's a nice fastball there on the outside black for a strike. North Georgia has put up runs in the first, a pair there, and then another one in the third. Momentum very much in the Nighthawk favor right now, trying to keep the pedal to the metal. The rock in the 0-1 is chopped up the middle, going to be a single and a run scored. The score now 4-0, North Georgia. Duncan comes across on the play. The RBI for McSwain on the year is her 10th of the season. And that brings up the first baseman, Finch, who I think has something in her eye. She was digging around in there.
Success.
Looks like she got it. She does a wave to the home plate umpire who's trying to buy her some time by cleaning off the plate. And she waved at her, said, we're fine, let's go. The ability to see when you're batting is so overrated. Finch at the dish. Flew out to center field in her first trip, 244 batting average. And there's a strike on the outside black to start her off. McSwain at first. Not much of a stolen base threat, just 1-2 on the year. But she is, or was, heavily used as a pinch runner. So some natural speed there. That pitch misses outside, 1-1. Just 3 stolen base threats really to speak of for North Georgia. 10 for Sprague, 12 for Anthony, and a big 22 coming out of Stephanie Hartness. 1-1 pitch bounces in the left-hand batter's box. It's 2-1. North Georgia gets their runs through execution and a little bit of long ball as well, as there are 3 Nighthawk hitters with 9 home runs or better on the season. 2-1 pitch. Looked like the runner might have been moving on it. And the ball pops out of the center fielder's mitt. Do they get her at second base? The base umpire was shielded on the play. He's going to ask for some help. Time is called, and all 3 umpires will convene here. He was turned around, looked at the center fielder who was making a sliding, diving attempt, and it kicked out of her mitt when the mitt hit the turf. So McSwain having to hold up because of that liner. She was beat at second base, but the throw was cut off by the second baseman. And then a little tiny flip to the shortstop who was covering, and that play was pretty close. They're going to call her out. So no hit there. That is a fielder's choice for Finch. And I guess that would go 8-4-6 if you're scoring at home. If you are, I feel bad for you. You should have better things to do with your time.
Well, if you're watching the...
Well, you can watch, but score a line. I mean, come on. Who does that?
I don't know. People just enjoy that.
Yes, enjoy. Enjoy. I used to do it as a kid. Went to a bunch of Phillies games as a kid. That's how I got my start in this gig here. Swung on and sent to the left side. Not going to go to second. Instead, they'll cut her down at first base. First pitch swinging was Sprague, and then coming across the third baseman to finish that off. But not before they pick up a run on two hits. No errors, and they leave one more out there. North Georgia all over this thing early. It's 4-0. Saints coming up in the fifth. Going to be Murphy Miller, and then the top of the order. We'll be right back. Top of the fifth inning from the Peach Belt Conference Tournament here at the Peeler Complex. Flagler down 4-0. It's starting to get a little bit late. Only got three trips left at the plate. I got to say, Saints probably got to get one this inning to shift that momentum back in their favor a little bit. Tall order, though, as Smith is dealing pretty well right now, has scattered a pair of hits and two errors. No free passes from her yet either, which is a good part of her game. No walks allowed by Smith. She makes you earn it up there. Morgan Murphy, the second baseman, puts a pretty good charge into this one to left center. Off the base of the fence, going to be extra bases. Murphy will check into second base. Nice throw there by Duncan, but nobody to catch it. It rolls through to first base. No advance on the play. But Morgan Murphy gets the Saints rolling here with a leadoff double in the fifth. Morgan's 2-for-2.
Yeah, exactly the start you need if you're looking to come back into this ball game. Three hits to North Georgia's five. It's just the fact that North Georgia's manufactured a lot more runs. And with a key situation here, runner on second and no outs, we're going to see what we can do here as she pops up a bunt to the third baseman for the first out in the inning.
So trying to sacrifice, instead gets the bat head underneath, and that is out number one. Murphy stays put at second base. Woodard, the shortstop now, as we head back to the top of the order. She's 1-for-2, a single, and a ground out. Off-speed pitch drops in there for a strike. Morgan Murphy on second base after that leadoff double. And Woodard thinks about a bunt, tips it foul. So now she's deep in the hole here, 0-2. Trying to bunt for a hit there again on the drag attempt. There Here comes the pitch. It's a fastball up. So 1-2 now the count for North Georgia. 4 runs on 5 hits, 2 errors for Flagler. No runs on 4 hits and 1 error.
No runs on 4 hits and 1 error.
So Flagler picked up their 4th hit with the double. And Woodard takes a look at another one there, battling back to even her count here, 2-2. 1 out, and Woodard trying to get the first run across the plate for Flagler here in the title game. Here comes that 2-2. It's a fastball up. How about that? Down 0-2. Woodard has worked the count full. First base empty. Big Al on deck. Smith with a payoff pitch on the way. Took a bit off. It's called strike 3. Might have been the change up there. Crossed up Woodard again. As Smith froze her for the strikeout.
So a leadoff double and a failed bunt attempt popped out to the third baseman and a strikeout. And Flagler is down to their last out in this half inning.
Just 2 strikeouts so far for Smith, and that comes after a big 14 against Francis Marion in their quarterfinal matchup yesterday. Cut on and missed here by Big Al. 2 down, going to take a clutch hit here from the right fielder. One pitch is fouled directly back to the fence. And the Saints right fielder going to have to shorten things up a little bit, get some contact. Good sized hole up the middle if she can send it right back where it comes from. It'll probably get through to the outfield. O-2 pitch, and it was a rise ball well up and out of the zone, but Big will be able to stay alive by fouling that off. O-2 comes inside and hit her. Time called at the plate. Yeah, okay, so they are going to have her head down. The umpire came out so quickly, I was worried they were calling foul ball on that it might have hit the bat instead. But anyway, it's a hit batsman, and Bagel gets bailed out there as she was deep in the hole, 0-2. And Mackenzie Conley, the catcher, the most potent bat in this Flagler lineup, will step up to the plate. A double and a ground out in her 2 trips, so 1-for-2. But a powerful bat here, a .333 batting average for Conley. Well outside to start her off 1-0.
Yeah, this is who you want to have up in this spot, a key spot in this game with 2 runners aboard. And like you mentioned, your best bat in your lineup, most powerful bat, most potent RBI bat up to the plate now. See what she can do.
1-0 came inside, and Conley got well out in front of it and fouled it off. So 1-1 now the count. Conley with the ability here to bring the Saints within a run with 1 swing of the bat. The 1-1 pitch, and that one is wrapped foul. Bounding ball to the third base side again. 1-2. Two outs here. And a 1-2 pitch on the way to the catcher. Comes inside and swung on a miss, struck her out. The fastball up and in, and Conley can't catch up with it. 4 out number 3. No runs on 1 hit, no errors, 2 left. We'll go to the bottom of the 5th now. With North Georgia out in front 4-0. We'll be right back. Okay, folks, we're in the bottom half of the fifth. Stephanie Hartness sat to play the solo home run in her last trip. She's 2-for-2 with a double and a homer. Starts her off outside 1-0. This is the first time she's faced the reliever Smith, though. It's just her and Frierson, the remaining two Nighthawks that haven't taken on this reliever today. As she came into the ball game back in the second. Another one in there for a strike. It's 1-1 now. Hartness hitting .431 on the season. 1-1 pitch. And that just misses outside. It's 2-1. At .431 batting average, you see that a lot in softball sometimes from slap hitters, you know, if they're real strong and can do a good job of placing the ball and beat out infield rollers and things like that. You don't often see a batting average that high out of, you know, a full swing like Hartness gives you. Slow roller to short, going to be a tight play at first, did get her. And they keep Hartness off the base paths for the first time today. One down in the fifth for Frierson. As Alicia is the designated player. She is, I think she's no official at bats. I think we got a sacrifice bunt and a walk for her. Fastball away, and it did pull the corner. Not a sacrifice bunt for Frierson, so she's 0-for-1, batting .384 now. A one pitch, and same spot there, same result. 0-2, that's a tough pitch. Even if Frierson goes out there, it's probably a slow roller to the right side. Good pitcher's pitch there from Smith back to back. 0-2. Had to go after it, and she swung on and missed on a pitch off the plate. Just kept stretching and stretching that zone further and further away from the right-hand batter. Two up, two down. That leaves the bases empty for Anthony, who is 0-for-1. She reached on a walk and then lined to short. 360 batting average for the right fielder. And she fouls the first pitch back to the fence. Two down, bottom of the fifth, the 0-1. And that bounces up there, a little bit outside as well. The 1-1 pitch misses outside as well. 2-1 count now for Anthony. Caitlin Smith working into her third inning in relief. 2 1/3 so far with just one earned run and one strikeout. Here comes that 2-1 pitch. It's lifted to the right side. Second baseman calls for it and grabs it. That's Morgan Murphy for out number three. Good inning there. 1-2-3 for the Saints. As now they'll take to the plate in the top of the sixth. Still North Georgia all over this one with a 4-0 lead. Be right back with more PBC softball from Milledgeville, Georgia. top of the sixth inning here from the Peeler Complex as North Georgia owning a 4-0 lead in the PBC title game. Looks like six tournament championships for North Georgia in their school's history, including the last three in a row. One of those was decided by a rainout. They were the highest seed remaining, and we had to close out the tournament. That was three years ago. But the last two here at Milledgeville at the Peeler Complex were won by North Georgia. And if things hold up here, it's going to be four in a row. But not if the Saints have anything to say about it. A 2-1 count here for Natalie Murphy, the first baseman, 364 hitter. And she is 0 for 2 today. Pop out to the second baseman. And a reach on an error by the pitcher, Smith.
Yep, Flagler down to their last six outs in this one. A lot of chances in this ball game that they just haven't been able to push across their first run of the ball game as of yet.
Swung on to the left side, and that's gloved nicely by McSwain. A high throw, but Finch had time for gravity to take over and bring her back down to the bag as that ball was hit pretty hard into McSwain's mitt. So one down for Maddie Murphy. The designated player is 0 for 2. A fly out to the catcher in foul territory. And then she lined into a double play. And she lifts the first pitch to the left side. It's grabbed by the shortstop for out number two as Sprague squeezes that one. Two up, two down.
Center fielder number three, Garland
Evans. And Garland Evans at the dish. She's 0 for 2 as well. A foul fly to the first baseman. And an error on the first baseman as she did reach once. First pitch swinging, and looks like she will be retired again here as Hartness grabs that one on the move for out number three. 1-2-3 go the Saints. It's getting late here in Milledgeville as North Georgia coming up for what could potentially be their last at bat, trying to get some insurance on this 4-0 lead. In the bottom of the sixth, it's Peach Belt Conference tournament title game. We'll be right back. Bottom half of the sixth inning from the Peeler Complex as North Georgia taken to the plate with a 4-0 lead. The Nighthawks have been opportunistic here in this ball game. Got two runs in the first on a wild pitch and an error in the first, or all on the same play. A solo home run in the third, then a double single combo in the fourth to get their 4-0 lead. That pitch away to start off Hammondtree. The catcher is 0 for 2. She's got a strikeout swinging and a grounder back to the pitcher. Shelby Hammondtree. Out in front of that one, yanks it foul, bounding ball that could have been trouble down in the corner, but she got a little bit too far out in front of it. Hammondtree, a freshman from Ringgold, Georgia, and Heritage High. My Georgia geography is good. I think Ringgold right across the border from Chattanooga, Tennessee. Rolled back to the pitcher, and that's a 1-3 put out. Second time in a row that Hammontree has grounded out to Smith there in the ring. So one down for Lexi Duncan. Duncan is 1-for-2, a double and a run scored in her last at bat. She also has a strikeout swinging. Swung on to the left side. This is going to be trouble. Coming up firing. Did she get her? Half a step, got her. Duncan, a speedy batter, or base runner, should say. And that's 6-3 there. Nice work from the shortstop, Woodard, to gun down the speedy Duncan. So two down, and the base is empty for the second baseman deep. A fly out to center and a ground out to second base. Cut on a miss there by deep. Hitting 205 now. Deep does not get cheated on her cuts. Whew. Man, bad intentions with every swing for this second baseman.
Trying to go deep.
Trying to go deep is deep. There's another big cut. It's like she's, just really giving everything on every swing there. See if she shortens it up with the 0-2 count. I guess it'll be no. I think she wants to put a hurting on that softball. Like it owes her money or something. 0-2 pitch coming up. Swung on and off the ankle of the pitcher Smith to short. Got her. Look at that. Kick save and a beauty there by Smith. And it ends up at short. The old conventional 1-6-3 put out finishes off the sixth. So North Georgia going to take their four-run lead into the top of the seventh. Let's see what we got coming up for the Saints. It'll be Capos, Murphy, and Miller, 7-8-9 due up in the Saint order. But Capos has been a star all weekend long. We'll see if she can continue it after this break. Got to get four to keep the game going if you're a Saint fan. We'll be right back with more PBC softball in just a moment. All right, top of the seventh, we got a defensive replacement for North Georgia. Morgan Helton will take over at second base for deep. So to finish things off here, the Nighthawks are hoping they'll add a little bit more defense out there. Capos at the plate, 0-for-2, and she cuts it the first one, fouls it back to the fence. Capos hitting 267, has had a great tournament here, though. All of her hits going for extra bases. A couple of doubles, a home run. She lifts this one foul back behind the plate, and enough, just enough territory for Shelby Hammontree to grab it. So that's the first out, and the Nighthawks get away with one there, as one of the tougher batters has retired relatively easy.
Yeah, not the start you wanted on the inning if you're a Saints fan.
Morgan Murphy, the second baseman, swung on and missed to start her off. Murphy, 245 batter, and she's getting it done today, folks, a single and a double, so a 2-for-2 effort from your number 8 hitter for the Saints. Smith, the rock in the fire, and it's tapped to short. Slow roller, could be trouble. Sprague over to first, just got her. Nice play, smooth play there from Sprague. And now the Saints are down to their final out. Megan Miller, the left fielder. Is the last ditch effort here for Flagler College. 207 hitter is Miller. She's 0 for 2 in this ball game. And she takes a look at one just on the black on the outside corner. 0-1. Slap hitter from the left side. Miller trying to prolong this tournament for her Saints. A little bit too far outside for Miller's liking there. It's a 1-1 count. Again, North Georgia pretty well into a regional. Might even have hosting duties, it appears. There are two sites in the softball regional. Flagler kind of on the bubble. Making this title game helps out a bunch. Slow roller up the middle to first. Got her by a half step. What a great way to finish. And a water bath there as all the water bottles get into play for Smith. The slow roller. Was that the second baseman, Sean, or the shortstop?
Shortstop.
It was the shortstop. So the 6-3 finish to close it out. What a great ball game played by both squads, really. Just a couple of small things and a couple of small advantages for North Georgia, and you can't allow such a seasoned and excellent team to have any opening. They're going to take advantage of them for sure. So North Georgia wins it with 4 runs on 5 hits, 2 errors. For Flagler, no runs, 4 hits, 1 error. As North Georgia wins their 7th Peach Belt Conference tournament title and their 4th in a row. And heck, their 3rd in a row here in Milledgeville. So that's a heck of a run for Mike Davenport and the gang. We are going to keep the stream up here, folks, as we get things ready for the post game. We're going to have our all-tournament team, which I have next to me. I'm not going to tell you who it is yet, though. You got to wait. Who's it going to be? Got to stick around, right? So we'll do that all-tournament team. Then we'll give the trophies for the runners-up and the champions in North Georgia. Congratulations as the North Georgia Nighthawks will take the Sydney. Okay, we're going to take the automatic bid to the NCAA Regional and win another title here in Milledgeville. As we get things set up there on the floor, the field, I'm going to take just a brief break. We'll turn the music down or the sound down here for just a second while we get everything in order up here in the press box and get ready for those post-game announcements. We'll be right back. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. It's time now for our post-tournament honors. Real quickly, if I can, how about a great weekend of softball here in Milledgeville? All 8 teams representing the Peach Belt Conference in the best possible way and a bunch of great ball games. Long ones at times, but great ball games. So we'll start first with the all-tournament team. And first from Armstrong State, Logan Harrell. Also from the Pirates of Armstrong State, Jane Traska. From Young Harris College, Jill Torres. Next up from Flagler College, Mackenzie Conley. From Flagler College, Maria Capos. Also from Flagler, Allie Marcano. Now from North Georgia, Jessica Finch. from North Georgia, Sydney Sprague. From North Georgia, Stephanie Hartness. And your tournament MVP from the University of North Georgia, Kylie Smith. And ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to honor our tournament runners-up, the trophy for the Flagler College Saints. Congratulations. And now, at this time, we will give you the tournament championship and the automatic bid to the NCAA Regional, the University of North Georgia Nighthawks. The seventh in school history and fourth straight Peach Belt Conference Tournament title. Congratulations. And now we will go through the roster one by one so they can receive their tournament goodies there. We'll start first with the freshman, Alicia Frierson. Sophomore, Morgan Helton. Freshman, Allison Neely. Freshman, Kaylin Anthony. Senior, Hannah McSwain. Freshman, Shelby Hammontree. Senior, Stephanie Hartness. Senior, Jessica Finch. Sophomore, Bria Bush. Junior, Brittany Gillum. Freshman, Amber Garrett. Sophomore, Kelly Kalert. Sophomore, Casey Oakley. Sophomore, Macy Watkins. Sophomore, Kaylee Turner. Junior, Sydney Sprague. Senior, Haley Robinson. Freshman, Kylie Smith. Sophomore, Whitney Worth. Freshman, Kristen Adkins. Freshman, Amber Johns. Sophomore, Jordan Deep. Freshman, Lexi Duncan. And the head coach of the North Georgia Nighthawks in his 17th season, Mike Davenport. Congratulations to the remainder of the coaching staff as well, Amanda Hawkins, Molly Child, Megan May, and Courtney Poole. Congratulations to the Nighthawks as well. As now we'll do some photos with our championship banner. Everybody get on out there. And fans, if you have any interest in taking photos for yourself, there are entrances on either side of the dugouts if you want to get right there on the field and get those photos taken care of. On behalf of the Georgia College Athletic Department, we thank you for attending the tournament this weekend. We had a joy hosting your young ladies of all your teams here this weekend. And we were excited to do that for a third straight season. Congratulations once again to all eight teams for making the tournament and for supplying some great softball this weekend. We wish all the teams the best that continue on to the next round of the NCAA regionals once those get announced. Congratulations once again, and please drive safely on your way home.